Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we'll be discussing the various functions of the entrepreneur. Kindly watch the video till the end, like it and subscribe. If you have any comments about the video, please put your comments in the comment box. So the functions of entrepreneurs are multifaceted, and these functions are broadly classified into four categories mainly: entrepreneurial functions, managerial functions, promotional functions, commercial functions. In the entrepreneurial functions, it is risk bearing, organizing, and innovation. In managerial functions, he performs planning, organizing, directing and controlling. In promotional functions, he performs the identification and selection of business idea, preparation of a business plan or a project report, then requirement of finance. Under commercial functions, an entrepreneur performs the production, manufacturing, marketing and accounting. Now let us discuss these functions in detail. So entrepreneurial functions, here under this one here, the risk bearing, of course it's very much difficult to imagine the risk which is involved in the business. An entrepreneur is an agent of the an agent who buys factors of production at a certain prices in order to combine them into a product with a view to sell those product at certain prices in future. And these prices are uncertain because it depends upon the market conditions, so which will decide the price. Even if he goes for selling such products at a very low price, then in such case the consumer may think that it is not a qualitative one. Suppose if you say, for example, if the price is charged a high rate, even in such case consumers may not affordable to it. So here the prices are uncertain here, and even the sum of the factors of production are uncontrollable. In such a case, an entrepreneur has to bear the risk, because sometimes he may not be owning those factors of production for which he has to make the reward at a high prices. He may not be owning a land, in such case he has to pay rent. He may not be owning a labor, in such case he has to pay wages. And even he may not be having the, say for example, the capital, then he has to borrow the funds, so that he has to bear the risk of payment of interest. An entrepreneur bears uncertainty here. Here, uncertainty is nothing but which is defined as a risk which cannot be insured. Say, for example, sometimes the business may be subjected to natural calamities, so which are totally unpredictable. You take, for example, the lockdown, which is totally unpredictable by these entrepreneurs. So, say, for example, when the government has stopped the economic activities for 3 months, it was difficult for an entrepreneur to imagine that would have come here. So the uncertainty can never be insured. A risk can be reduced through the insurance principle, that's all. But here, in the entrepreneur cannot avoid the risk in the business. So now let us move to the next here, organizing. Here, organizing is nothing but the ability of an entrepreneur to combine all the factors of production. The entrepreneur is the one who combines the land belonging to one person, the labor of another, and the capital of yet another, and thus produces a product here. The entrepreneur should have the art of superintendence and administration in order to ensure a smooth functioning of production and other functions of the management, he should have the skill of supervising all the factors of production and administering the cost controlling here. An entrepreneur must be ready to face the challenges and overcome those obstacles, because these challenges will be there in the business. Maybe such a challenge may be posed by the situation, or it may be, say, for example, posed by the consumers. So he must formulate his own strategies to overcome such challenges, obstacles, and face the challenges. Take, for example, in the year 2017, the government introduced goods and service tax. Earlier, there was a VAT, that is value added tax. So when this new system has come, he must ready to incorporate such new changes in his business. However, it may take some time, but he must be in a position to accept the change and should continue here. Today you may be knowing, even in case of the telecommunication business, there is a greater competition. Earlier you may be knowing that the Airtel was having the brand, and now most of the people, they go for usage or using of the Reliance Jio, which has given a keen competition to other service providers. So the entrepreneur should ready to face the challenges, and if there are any obstacles, he must have his own plan to overcome such problems here. Now the next one comes here, innovation. Here innovation refers to performing new things or doing the things that already being done in a new way. If you take the example of telecommunication itself, before the introduction of the usage of this internet, earlier these service providers targeted the students community by providing 100 SMSs. So the same service is provided with a different dimension here. According to Schumpeter, an entrepreneur is an innovator who introduces combinations of means of production. Innovation includes the introduction of a new product. Say, for example, you may be knowing the product called as the Horlicks. Earlier, the Horlicks was meant only for the kids, but today even the Horlicks is now introduced as a necessary product for the pregnant women. Then introduction of a new method of production, then opening of a new market. Take for example, there is now greater demand for the sale of the masks because of the COVID pandemic. So here most of the people, they started producing the masks. Some people started, say for example, the masks which were used for surgery. And again, you find the refinement in the product. You take, for example, Ramraj, which was a brand called as Ramraj, which was meant for producing the men's dresses. Now it has started with the manufacturing of those masks. Even if you take, for example, the Lenin, it has started manufacturing of the mask. So it will find a new market. Even if you take, for example, the hotels which were earlier only serving for the people who come into the hotel, even they have started a parcel counter. So all these, nothing but you are starting the you are doing the business with a different dimensions. Discovery of a new source of supply of raw materials, carrying out the new form of organization of any industry. So all these, they are included in the innovation. Here the research is also required to go for introducing a new product or a new method of production or opening of a new market. So there exists a difference between a research and innovation. So now let us look in what kind of the differences are there between the research and innovation. Research is, it seeks to produce knowledge. Say for example, when an experiment will take, it will add to the knowledge. Whereas the innovation, it seeks to produce the objects with the work and can be sold. That means whatever the knowledge is there, that will be materialized in the commercial form to sell the things here. Research is completely dependent on the researcher. So how he understands the things. So based on the based on his knowledge, he develops his own the method of production or the method of theory. Whereas innovation is based on the knowledge produced by research, it is completely independent of research. For the research, management is not interested in the research because it is not in the commercial, it doesn't have any commercial viability. Whereas innovation, it requires relevant information about the markets, then how the patents can be generated for the management here. Even the innovation is different from invention. So now let us look into what is the difference between invention and innovation. Invention is the discovery of new ideas, new articles and new methods. That means it is completely related with the exploring of new ideas or bringing some modification in the existing products or finding the new methods here. Whereas innovation is application of inventions and a discovery to make combination and thereby produce satisfaction and profits. That means here innovation is the ultimate end which results comes into results. Invention helps to facilitate innovations, whereas innovation is having little benefit of mankind unless it is marketable. So here innovation is a totally a commercial phenomena, whereas that means that will result into a profit to the entrepreneur. Now let's move to the next type of the functions, that is managerial functions. So among here, among the managerial functions, the planning. Of course, in a very simple terms, planning is nothing but thinking before doing. Before if you start up any business or before if you start doing any work, so the planning is required in order for the smooth functioning here. Henry Fayol defines management is nothing but to forecast, to plan, to organize, to command, to coordinate, and to control. The management functions are performed by the entrepreneurs. Here, planning pervades in all the aspects of business. Say, for example, it is related with the procuring of the funds, marketing of the products, or it may be related with the production of the goods. So an entrepreneur has to make decisions as to what is to be done, how it is to be done, when it is to be done, where it is to be done, by whom it is to be done, and so on. The importance of planning lies in the fact that it ensures the smooth and effective completion and running of a business enterprise. If there is a failure in the planning here, then it's very much difficult to run the business here. Then the next one comes here, organizing. Here, organizing refers to the bringing of a 4M. That is, it's a combination of men, money, material, machine, etc. to execute the plans. Thus, organizing function of an entrepreneur ultimately provides a mechanism for purposive, integrated and cooperative action. So every business has its own objective. So the entrepreneur has to organize in such a way that the purpose is achieved. So he needs to integrate all the factors of production. For that also he needs to plan, and those things should be integrated. Organizing is nothing but an organized efforts to implement a business plan. So when an entrepreneur plans for starting of a business, he should perform all the functions of the management. Then the next one comes here, staffing. Of course, this staffing is related with the decision regarding the human resources and managing the human resources. So here, staffing function of an entrepreneur includes preparing the inventory of personnel. That means he has to decide whether the entrepreneur is in need of skilled labor or unskilled labor or semi-skilled labor. Then even he should go for requirement of the decide the requirement of the personnel. How many people he needs for the such production or for his enterprise. I mean to say, he has to decide the number of the persons to be employed for the running the business. Even he should decide the sources of the manpower. So where the labor is available. You may be knowing, say, for example, for if you take the construction industry, normally the tiles fitting are made by Rajasthani people. So you need to decide the source of the manpower and their selection, remuneration. So you should pay them because they are putting their efforts. So how the selection procedure should take place. So all these things he should decide, whether he should go for only walk-in interview or he should conduct any aptitude test to check his aptitude skill of the employee. Then once the people are employed, always they expect the hike or the growth in their job. So there should be periodic appraisal of the personnel working in the enterprise. The NF Rick had remarked that business houses are made or broken in the long run, not by markets or capital or patents, but by men. This is a very clear definition given by L.F. Lurick, that me who says here, the growth of the business houses is exclusively depending upon the quality of the human resources employed by the entrepreneur. Now, then let's go for the next function, that is directing. The directing function of an entrepreneur actually starts from the setting up of the business. The entrepreneur guides, counsels, teaches, stimulates, and activates his or her employees. Because the entrepreneur should give the knowledge how the things are to be operated. Say, for example, when there is a purchase of new machinery by the entrepreneur, he should teach his employees how to utilize the machine during the course of production. So this is more action oriented here. Directing is a final function of an entrepreneur in making the employees actually act after all the preparations have been completed. So here, the directing is nothing but which is action oriented and which is the source for the production and the sale, etc. Here, and then the next one comes here, controlling. This is the final function of the management. The entrepreneur should have control over all the factors of production. The controlling is nothing but the comparison of the actual performance with the plant. So he has to make an evaluation of those activities which are performed by him, whether they are they with in accordance with the standards or the target performance here. And he should also identify if there are any deviations, and he should also address how those deviations can be addressed here. And he should also take the corrective measures to achieve the targets. If there is no controlling here, then it's very much difficult to have control over increasing the cost of production, etc. here. So he should decide what is to be done actually in order to have the control over the production here. Now let us move to the another type of the functions, that is promotional functions. It is related with the starting of an enterprise and also the sale, etc. here. So here, identification and selection of business idea. An entrepreneur may have several ideas in his mind. He should select such an idea which is financially viable to him. An entrepreneur is interested in a profitable venture always. The selection of the most suitable business project involves a process. The starting of entrepreneurship is based on the experience of the entrepreneur, his knowledge and information gathered from friends and relatives. When he has several options before him, he has to decide which option is better for him. The financial viability is assessed comparing the cost and benefit analysis. The most beneficial idea is selected. Take for example, a person may have several ideas. If you take the example of telecommunication only, some people, they are much interested only in usage of the net packs, whereas some people who are interested, say for example, only in the call. So today you may find that these telecommunication service providers, they have a different plans of net packs. Some they need to cater the needs of all the types of customers. So that's why today you find 84 days validity in net packs, or say for example, if you go for daily 1.5 GB net pack, 2 GB net pack like this here. So there are varieties of the customers. The entrepreneur should meet all the needs of such customers. So that's why he is required to identify and select a proper business idea. Then next comes here, preparation of a business plan and the project report. Here, business plan is nothing but well evolved course of action devised by an entrepreneur to achieve the specified objectives within a specified time. It's a mandatory, the preparation of the business plan is mandatory to obtain financial assistance from the financial institutions. A business plan is nothing but which provides the total outlay of the project. That means it will decide about how much fixed capital is required, how much working capital is required, and based on that, if the B plan is very sound, if it is very appropriate, then the financial institutions come forward for financing such an enterprise. Here, this business plan contains information about the intending entrepreneur. It will tell about the kind of the entrepreneur, location of the business enterprise, whether it comes in rural, urban or city here. Then requirement of the land, how much is the land? The land is to be purchased or is it whether it can be taken on a rental basis here. Then building, plant and machinery, raw material, utilities, transport and communication, manpower, capital, along with your sources of supply, break-even point and implementation of the schedule of the project. So it provides all the details of the enterprise here. right from scratching of the head till the ultimately the product is produced, everything that will be mentioned in the B plan. Then the next comes here, requirement of the finance. Of course, finance is the lifeblood of the business. The entrepreneur prepares requirement of funds with its detailed structure here. Here, as we told here, whether he it is to decided that whether he has own funds for starting of the business, or whether he requires borrowed funds, or whether the funds which are with him are not sufficient for the running the business, in such case he has to borrow. When he has to borrow the funds here, then he needs to provide an appropriate B plan to the financing authorities here. And even he should decide the quantum of the fixed capital and the quantum of the working capital in his business. The sources through which such funds can be raised are also to be mentioned. That means whether owned funds or borrowed funds. If it is borrowed funds, is it borrowing from the banks, or is it through the launching of an initial public offer, etc. So all those things that are to be decided by him here. Then the next type of functions comes here, commercial functions. Here we have got several things here, production and manufacturing. Production function includes decisions relating to the selection of factory site, design and layout, then the types of the products to be produced, then research and development and design of a product here. So always a product is subject to modification. So how that can be modified, that is done with the help of the research and development. And even you should design the product also. Then the supporting services include the production, planning, control, maintenance and repair, purchasing, storekeeping and material handling. The effective production depends on the production planning and control here. So in total, we can say that the entrepreneur should ascertain where the raw materials are available, how they can be brought to the factory site. Then he should decide what type of the products he should be producing, say whether it is industrial goods or whether is it a consumable goods. So all those things to be decided. And the produce, he should also look after that the produced goods should reach the market also. Then he should also think of storing of such goods, when they must be, say for example, launched in the market. So all those things that should be decided by the entrepreneur here. Then the next one comes here, marketing here. Of course, marketing is nothing but the performance of those business activities that direct the flow of goods and services from the producer to the ultimate consumer here. Today, the market is driven by the customers. Whatever the customers desired by him here, the same thing should be produced. Let me give you an example here of the transportation. You may be knowing that the berths are available only in the trains. But today you find AC buses, you find sleeper coach buses. This is because of the taste of the consumers. And you find today almost all the amenities are available. Even if you take, for example, because of this COVID pandemic, even the transportation has changed a lot. Even they started providing the sanitization to their passengers. The hygienic things are provided here. So these marketing activities, they are like of standardization, packaging, pricing, storage, promotional activities and the distribution channel here. The success of marketing function is linked with an appropriate marketing mix. Of course, there are four marketing mix here. That is, it is a component of the marketing mix are the product, price, promotion and physical distribution of the goods, packaging, people and the process. Then the next one comes here, the accounting here. Of course, the main objective of any business enterprise is to earn profits and create wealth. When you look into the definition as given by American Institute of Certified Public Accountants, which defines accounting as it's the art of recording the transactions, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money transaction and event which are in part at least of a financial character and interpreting the results thereof. Here the accounting involves a process which consists of the recording the transactions, classifying the transactions, summarizing the transactions, preparing of the final accounts and analyzing and interpreting the results thereof here. So here the ultimate the accounting will provide you the profit, and that will be the nothing but the achieving the objective of the entrepreneur. Thank you for watching this video.